Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa at Sakhir Palace in the presence of His Majesty the King's Representative for Humanitarian Work and Youth Affairs, National Security Advisor and National Security Advisor and Youth Affairs, National and Royal Guard Commander His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, Royal Court Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, BDF Commander in Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, Interior Minister General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, Foreign Affairs Minister Dr. Rashid bin Abdullah Al Zayani, and Finance and National Economy Minister Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa. His Majesty the King reviewed a number of topics pertaining to ways to further enhance the comprehensive development process currently witnessed by the Kingdom in all fields. His Majesty expressed his deep pride in the honorable role played by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, citing His Royal Highness's fruitful efforts to bring about more progress to the Kingdom through developing all paths of government work, launching promising developmental and housing initiatives and projects aimed at achieving the best for the nation and the citizens, as well as consolidating the Kingdom's advanced standing in development indicators, lauding the Kingdom's wide-ranging achievements that have covered all aspects of life and reflected positively on the Bahraini people. His Majesty appreciated the Kingdom's success in organizing many specialized exhibitions and conferences recently, as well as regional and global events and sports championships, contributing to consolidating its leading position and prestigious reputation in all fields. His Majesty the King also thanked citizens and residents for the noble feelings they expressed during the Kingdom's celebration of its national days. On the occasion of the new year, His Majesty the King wished the Kingdom as people further progress and prosperity, as well as security, peace and stability to all countries. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received the newly appointed Ambassador of Russia to Bahrain, Alexei Skosirev, at Rifa' Palace. His Royal Highness highlighted the long-standing relations between Bahrain and Russia, emphasizing the importance of further developing and strengthening joint cooperation and coordination to benefit both countries and its people. His Royal Highness welcomed the Ambassador's appointment to the Kingdom and wished him success in his diplomatic duties. During the meeting, issues of common interest and regional and global developments were discussed. The Ambassador expressed his appreciation for His Royal Highness's commitment to strengthening relations between the two countries to achieve common goals and wished the Kingdom further progress and prosperity. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa and the Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, also attended the meeting. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received the newly appointed Ambassador of Nepal to Bahrain, Tritha Raj Wagle, at Rifa' Palace. His Royal Highness highlighted the steady growth of Bahraini-Nepalese relations, emphasizing the importance of further strengthening coordination and cooperation to advance common interests. His Royal Highness welcomed the Ambassador's appointment to the Kingdom and wished him success in his diplomatic duties. During the meeting, issues of common interest and regional and global developments were discussed. For his part, the Ambassador expressed appreciation for His Royal Highness's commitment to supporting cooperation between the two countries and wished the Kingdom further progress and prosperity. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa also attended the meeting. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa issued Edict 66 of the year 2022, restructuring the Council for Regulating the Practices of Engineering Professions based on the proposal of the Minister of Works and following the approval of the Cabinet. According to the Edict, the Council for Regulating the Practices of Engineering Professions shall be restructured as follows. Dr. Abdullah Yusuf Talib Abdul Ghani, Chairman. Engineer Abdel Nabi Abdullah Asbah, Deputy Chairman. Engineer Isa Ali Janahi, Member. Engineer Khalid Mohammed Al Ansari, Member. Engineer Ghada Hamid Al Marzouk, Member. Engineer Noor Ja'far Al Mtawa, Member. Engineer Mohammed Mirza Al Arabi, Member. Engineer Reem Ibrahim Khalfan, Member. Engineer Maryam Mohammed Shams Al Ansari, Member of the Council, shall serve for a 3-year term that can be renewed once. Under the patronage of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, the graduation ceremony of the 15th batch of officer candidates Al Qadisiyya Brigade was held at Isa Royal Military College. His Majesty the King delegated the BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa to patronize the ceremony. Upon arrival at the ceremony location, the BDF Commander-in-Chief was received by the Minister of Defense Affairs, Lieutenant General Abdullah Naimi, and the Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Diab Naimi. The ceremony began with the national anthem. Then Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed inspected the graduates' queue. Then the graduates' military parade began.
السلام عليكم. تفتيش ابو الخريجي سيد.
وأعدوا لهم ما استطعتم من قوة ومن رباط الخيل ترهبون به عدو الله وعدوكم وآخرين من دونهم لا تعلمونهم الله يعلمهم وما تنفقوا من شيء في سبيل الله يوفى إليكم وأنتم لا تظلمون وإن جنحوا للسلم فاجنح لها وتوكل على الله إنه هو السميع العليم.
السلام عليكم. بابا الحسين.
تزدان كلية عيسى العسكرية الملكية بحضوركم فرحاً وتتهلل بمعاليكم بشراً بتشريفكم حفلة تخريج دورة مرشحي الضباط الدفعة 15 سرية القادسية. سيدي صاحب المعالي، ها هم رجال البحرين يتقدمون بخطوات ثابتة، يتقدمون نحو مجد مشرق، حاملين شعار الله الملك الوطن، يتقدمون ومعهم إخوتهم من دولة فلسطين والجمهورية اليمنية، حيث نبارك لأهلهم تواجدهم معنا وتخرج أبنائهم.
سيدي صاحب المعالي القائد العام، بداية أتقدم باسمي.
The commander of the Isa Royal Military College, Major General Abdurrahman Khalifa Naimi, delivered a speech on the occasion in which he expressed appreciation to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, for patronizing the ceremony. He noted that the graduation ceremony coincides with Bahrain's National Day celebrations. The commander affirmed that the candidates pledged allegiance to make sacrifices and defend the kingdom. He also expressed pleasure with the participation of a number of officer candidates from Yemen and Palestine, as they are united by brotherhood and common destiny. He stated that the college is actively seeking development in all aspects and conducted studies with the aim of advancing the college's outputs and preparing future leaders. He also said that the Bachelor of Military Science program was approved for a period of 3 academic years, and the option for graduate officers to complete their academic studies in partnership with the University of Bahrain. A graduate also delivered a speech in which he expressed honor in welcoming the guests on behalf of his fellow graduates and celebrating the 15th batch of officer candidates, Al-Qadisiyya Brigade, at the Isa Royal Military College, where they learned various military sciences and academic lessons. The candidate officer, Hassan Rashid Al-Buflasa, then recited a poem on the occasion.
القائد الأعلى للقوات المسلحة حفظه الله ورعاه، داعين الله العلي القدير أن يعيد هذه المناسبة المجيدة بمزيد من العزة والرحى والتقدم والازدهار. تشهدون اليوم تخريج نخبة من ضباط الميدان بعد أن أنهوا المتطلبات العسكرية والأكاديمية وتلقوا أحدث العلوم العسكرية وفنون القيادة ومهارات القتال. يملأهم الحماس والعزم، مستعدين لبذل أرواحهم دفاعاً عن الوطن، مؤكدين عهد الولاء لله والملك والوطن. كما يسعد الكلية مشاركة عدد من مرشحين الضباط من الجمهورية اليمنية الشقيقة ودولة فلسطين الشقيقة في الدورة، جنباً إلى جنب مع أخوانهم في مملكة البحرين، حيث تجمعهم الأخوة والعروبة والمصير المشترك.
سيدي صاحب المعالي، إنه لشرف كبير أن أقف أمام معاليكم في هذا اليوم المبارك وفي رحاب كلية عيسى العسكرية الملكية. أصالة عن نفسي ونيابة عن زملائي الخريجين، يشرفني أن أرحب بمقدم معاليكم حفظكم الله في حفل تخريج دورة مرشحي الضباط الدفعة 15 سرية القادسية، التي نهلنا منها شتى العلوم العسكرية ومختلف الدروس الأكاديمية تحت مظلة هذا الصرح العلمي الشامخ، كلية عيسى العسكرية الملكية، منبع العلوم والمعارف العسكرية وميدان العلم الأكاديمي الحديث. بهذا اليوم الأغر الذي تعانقت به رايات العزة والمجد، نجدد عهدنا بالولاء والطاعة لسيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة، ملك البلاد المعظم، القائد الأعلى للقوات المسلحة حفظه الله ورعاه. ونؤكد المضي قدماً في مسيرة التطور التي تشهدها قواتنا المسلحة، تواقين لخوض ميادين التضحية، معاهدين الله عز وجل أن نكون جنودكم مخلصين رهن إشارتكم وطوع بنانكم، باذلين أرواحنا للدفاع عن حياض الوطن وحصن منيع لمنجزات ومكتسبات مملكتنا الغالية.
على العهد نبقى يا أبو سلمان، أبشر بنا لثارة الهية يا راعي الغوج، اللي ما ينشرى بثمان كسب الكريم، اللي افعوله نداويه ويا سليل قومن مجدهم من ازمان، فعالي السمع بارق نضيه على الخليفه، صيتهم يرعب العدوان درع الوطن فالوغى لثارعيه، على الخليفه صيتهم يرعب العدوان درع الوطن فالوغى لثارعيه، لباسه الشال عزوه العربان هم در المضيوم وهم فيه، فيهم ولي العهد رفيع الشان الفخر يفخر، لهب طارية والمشير قايدنا في يوم الوغى لحان، فسموا في الأرض وقوات بحرية واختامها بالمبتدا باسم الله الرحمن. يا مرحبا يا سيدي وأهلين يا حية.
Then the BDF Commander-in-Chief was briefed on the candidate's officer's course, and he honored the outstanding students.
الحائز على المركز الأول وسيف الشرف مرشح ضابط عبد الله عيسى محمد عبد الله. الحائز على المركز الثاني مرشح ضابط عبد الله حمد عبد الله الدوسري. الحائز على المركز الثالث مرشح ضابط عبد الرحمن طارق محمد حسن. الحائز على المركز الأول على الدول الشقيقة مرشح ضابط يعقوب رزق عطا يعقوب من دولة فلسطين الشقيقة. الحائز على جائزة الضبط والربط العسكري مرشح ضابط إبراهيم طارق عبد العزيز البعينين. الحائز على جائزة اللياقة البدنية مرشح ضابط أنس محمود غالب سوالمة من دولة فلسطين الشقيقة. الحائز على جائزة الرماية مرشح ضابط لؤي محمود عبد سالم من دولة فلسطين الشقيقة. يمنح نوط التميز للحائز على المركز الأول في الدورة مرشح ضابط عبد الله عيسى محمد عبد الله.
After that, the ceremony of handing over and receiving the banner of the Isi Royal Military College from the graduating class of Al-Qadisiyah Brigade to the new 16th class, Ahmed Al-Fatih Brigade, took place.
فوقة عالية باسم الجبهة الثانية 16 يعاهدكم أمام الله أمام الملك حافظ عليها حتى آخر غزة من نمان.
سيدي صاحب المعالي، أيها الحفل الكريم، صدر الأمر الملكي السامي لسيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة ملك البلاد المعظم القائد الأعلى للقوات المسلحة حفظه الله ورعاه رقم 88 على عين لعام 2022 بتعيين الخريجين ضباطاً في قوة دفاع البحرين. الخريجون قسم الخدمة العسكرية ويلقيه مدير الإرشاد الديني العميد.
Then the graduates took the legal oath.
أقسم بالله العظيم،
أقسم بالله العظيم،
أقسم بالله العظيم، باعتباري عسكرياً في قوة الدفاع، أن أكون وفياً لمملكة البحرين، أميناً على حقوقها، مخلصاً لمليكها، صاحب الجلالة الملك المعظم، القائد الأعلى للقوات المسلحة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة، مطيعاً لجميع الأوامر الحقة التي تصدر إلي من رؤسائي، منفذاً لها في البر والجو والبحر داخل وخارج المملكة، وأن أضع نفسي وقدراتي في خدمة المملكة، وأن أحمي علمها وأحفظ أمنها واستقلالها وسلامة أراضيها، معاديا من يعاديها، مسالما من يسالمها، محافظا على شرفي وسلاحي، لا أتركه حتى أذوق الموت، والله على ما أقول شهيد.
السلام عليكم إسراف أبو الخريجين سيد.
ينصرف الخريجون من الميدان ولسان حالهم يقول: لن ننسى أياما مضت، لن ننسى ذكراها، لن ننسى ميادين التدريب وقاعات العلم والمعرفة، بعد أن نهلوا من معين كلية عيسى العسكرية الملكية حظا وافرا من التأهيل والتدريب ما يؤهلهم أن يكونوا ضباطاً أكفاء في ميادين البطولة، متميزين بكل معاني والقيم العسكرية الحقة بالتضحية والإيثار. ها هم الخريجون وهم يغادرون الميدان بخطوات واثقة، يرتقون سلم المجد لتبدأ بعدها مسيرة جديدة مليئة بالعطاء في أعظم مهمة وأنقى رسالة وأشرف ميدان، ميدان الجندية. يرتقي الخريجون أولى درجات الاحترافية متسلحين بما تزودوا به من علم ومعرفة ومهارات عسكرية ساهمت في صقل شخصيتهم وتطوير مكتسباتهم، وهو ما يفتح أمامهم الطريق نحو مزيد من العلم والمعرفة في وحدات قوة دفاع البحرين، ليصبحوا قادرين على أداء دورهم ورسالتهم في خدمة الوطن.
The BDF Commander-in-Chief presented the graduates with the Military Science Diplomas. On the occasion of the BDF Commander-in-Chief expressed his thanks to His Majesty the King for patronizing the graduation ceremony, as well as his support of the BDF's development. He congratulated the graduates and expressed hope that they will utilize the knowledge they gained in serving the armed forces and contributed to the development of the kingdom. He welcomed the graduates from Yemen and Palestine, wishing them further success. Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed expressed thanks to all Isa Royal Military College for their efforts in the development of the college and success of the ceremony. The BDF Commander-in-Chief praised the advanced status of the military educational institutions in Bahrain and affirmed their importance in serving the kingdom's armed forces. He also noted that this national role is a translation of the military approach based on the visions of His Majesty the King. He also noted that since the establishment of the BDF, it was keen on the support and development of human resources in all fields. He expressed his pride in the BDF personnel and their efforts and role that contributed to the BDF's high status that enabled it to protect national gains and achievements. He stressed that the BDF has become a role model in combat performance and military training. Thank you. The Council of Representatives held its weekly meeting, chaired by its speaker, Ahmed Al-Musallam. The Council approved the message sent by the chairman of the committee to study the government plan for the years 2023-2026 on the request to extend the work of the committee for 10 days. The Council also approved the names of the representatives for the committee to prepare a draft response to the royal speech. It also approved the names of the representatives for the membership of the Executive Committee of Bahrain Parliamentary Division. The 33rd edition of the Autumn Fair continues with the participation of 650 exhibitors from 14 countries. More in this report.
The return of the Autumn Fair heralds a remarkable recovery of the exhibition industry in Bahrain and will benefit the commercial and tourism sectors in line with the objectives of Bahrain's Tourism Strategy 2022-2026 within the Economic Recovery Plan. It also provides a seasonal shopping experience that many citizens, residents and visitors look forward to every year, as it brings together a large number of local, regional and international companies and products under one roof, such as food, textiles, clothing, perfumes, cosmetics and many more. This year's exhibition is expected to attract a large number of visitors.
We are very happy to participate in Bahrain. We are most happy to participate in Bahrain. This is our ninth participation in Bahrain, and we every year like there is something new in the exhibitions, and we are very happy to be here.
Our company, it's Elias Textile. We used to join Bahrain shows since more than 15 years, and it's first time for us in the new conversion center. It was very nice.
The activities of the Autumn Fair also play an important role in attracting tourists and enriching the experience of visitors to Bahrain by adding a distinctive marketing and entertainment feature to their tourism program, which will reflect positively on the tourism sector and the national economy.
The Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Bangladesh, in cooperation with the Embassy of Bangladesh in the Kingdom of Bahrain, organized Visit Bangladesh 2022 program. More in this report.
The Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Bangladesh organized the Visit Bangladesh Program 2022, bringing together delegations from various countries to enjoy the history and culture of the country. The Minister of Foreign Affairs of Bangladesh, Dr. Abul Kalam Abdul Mu'min, and the State Minister, Muhammad Shahryar Alam, received the delegation's members and briefed them about the history and culture of Bangladesh.
This is a part of our regular program of the Foreign Ministry, the Visit Bangladesh Program, where we invite the foreign media person, writers, civil society members to visit Bangladesh so that we can portray a positive outlook and our very developmental activities of Bangladesh to the world.
After that, the delegation visited the Bangabandhu Museum. It's the house of where the father of the nation, Mujibur Rahman, lived with his family.
This is the living house of our father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. He started live here from 1961 on October.
The journey also included a visit to the University of Dhaka, which is the oldest university in Bangladesh. The university opened its doors to students on July 1, 1921, and it is currently the largest public research university in Bangladesh.
Dhaka University is the oldest and the highest university in University of Dhaka and in Bangladesh. The university was situated in the year of 1921, and this university comprised of 84 departments, and each year we take 6,700 students, and now the total number of students is 37,000 approximately.
The delegations then visited the Shaheed Minar and the Liberation Monument, which honors the fight of Bangladesh to protect their mother language.
So the name of this monument is Oporajeya Bangla, and it represents the symbol of pride of Bangladesh. You know, we got our independence in 1971 under the leadership of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the father of the nation. And the present Prime Minister, Sheikh Hasina, she is the daughter of the father of the nation. And under her leadership, we are achieving many things currently. So this is the, I already added that this is the pride of symbol. And through this monument, we represent the history, the historical background to the history of our liberation.
The program was a special opportunity for delegations around the world to visit Bangladesh and be educated on its various cultures and history.
Visit Bangladesh Program 2022 brings together delegations from all around the world to be introduced about the history, the fight, and the freedom of Bangladesh and the process of development it is witnessing now. Reporting for Bahrain International, I am Hamad Youssef.